Some time ago, I adopted a new habit. I started waking up at 5 a.m. in the morning and getting a workout in. Well, when it was still possible to go to the gym, because, you know, we live in different times now. Now, I adopted this new habit because I wanted to change things up. I wanted to have more free time to do more with my day. You see, not having to work out after my 9-to-5 job allowed me to do other things such as filming, take pictures, edit videos, go to the movies throughout the week instead of waiting for the weekend. However, although I enjoyed this routine, and I'll be sharing a video on that in the near future, I found myself not sticking to it 100%. Now, of course, it's not easy to wake up so early in the morning, especially if you're not a morning person like me. But the fact that I was not sticking to it like I should wasn't necessarily due to the fact that I couldn't wake up that early. Instead, it had more to do with the motivating factor for me to do so. Alright, so today I want to share with you guys some of the things that have helped me along the way to stay motivated and stay consistent with the goals that I set throughout the week. Whether it's waking up at 5 a.m., working out, or reading a chapter of a book, I'm pretty sure these tips can make a difference for you too. So let's start with the first thing, which is planning and organizing the things that you actually want to do. When I first started waking up at 5 a.m., I had a clear purpose for doing it. The goal and the motivating factor for me to keep up with that routine was documenting my experience. But the motivation to keep up with that routine quickly diminished when I finished documenting my experience. I suddenly found myself not really seeing the point of waking up at such an early time. So for me to keep up with that routine, I had to plan out what I wanted to do with my free time. Whether it was editing a new video, planning out Instagram content, going out and taking pictures, or filming, I had to put it on the agenda. Doing this allowed me to keep myself accountable and excited about the day ahead. So the second thing I want to share with you guys has to do with procrastination and overthinking. How many times have you been a victim of leaving things for later on, only to end up not doing them at all? Think about hitting a workout, for example. I feel kind of tired right now, so I'll go in an hour. Or, I'm kind of hungry right now, so I'll cook first and then I'll go train. Now, how many times did you actually go and work out after having those moments? Okay, so maybe you did actually go and work out, but you can't deny that you were not tempted to skip that workout. Now, if we're talking about overthinking, I, for example, tend to overthink the process of creating a video. I tend to get in my head and think of all the negative aspects of shooting a clip and why I can't do it. Now, the result of this is that I end up feeling discouraged about creating something, which completely kills my creativity. The problem starts with that first thought. Allowing those negative thoughts to take charge inside your head opens the door for more and more of those thoughts. Now, what can you actually do about this process of overthinking and procrastination? Now, the way that I personally try to cope with this process is by applying a method that I learned while listening to an audible about the book, The 5-Second Rule. So the idea behind this rule was that as soon as you find yourself overthinking and procrastinating, you have 5 seconds to act on it. By doing so and acting within that 5-second window, you give yourself a higher chance of actually executing what you were planning to do. Okay, so in general, don't allow yourself to fall into that trap of overthinking and procrastinating. Get busy if you're sitting down. Stand up if your thoughts start taking over. Scream no! And believe me, you might look a bit crazy, but once you start keeping track of those key moments, you will feel like you're in control instead of letting your thoughts take the lead. The third thing I do to keep myself motivated is to look for inspiration around me. I mean, it's cool when ideas just pop into your head, but sometimes no matter how hard you try, you just can't come up with any ideas. Well, at least any good ones. This is where social media comes in clutch. YouTube, Instagram, or Pinterest can be an incredible source of inspiration. I usually get inspired myself when I see a cool transition or effect. Something like that, for example. Pretty cool, right? Now, although gyms are still closed, seeing a new exercise that I haven't done before, or that I maybe haven't done in a while, gets me excited to go ahead and try it out. So whatever you're into, maybe it's makeup, maybe it's cars, maybe it's cooking, getting inspiration from other people can lead to you feeling inspired and motivated to get back at it. All right, so I don't want to end up this video on a cheesy note, but what it eventually comes down to is remembering why you started and why you love doing what you're actually doing. Waking up at 5 a.m. for me gave me the freedom to not feel like I was living up to the weekend. So sticking to that routine was definitely something that I wanted to keep up with. So by doing the things that I've discussed with you throughout this video, I've been able to somewhat keep up with that routine. It's still a struggle, but these things have definitely helped me along the way to stay accountable and stay motivated. So hopefully they can help you out too. All right, guys, so hopefully you guys really enjoyed this video. And if you did, then don't forget to hit that like button. Remember, as always, that I'm a certified personal trainer. So if you're looking for an online personal trainer, a meal plan, or a workout routine, then hit me up on embeddedbodies.com, right? But with that being said, guys, I'm gonna finish off this video right here. Let me know in the comments down below what you thought of this video and what videos you would like to see next. So stay safe, and I guess I'll see you guys soon. Later, guys.